We are sitting inside of a 2010 Ford Fusion, and the customer complaint is it makes a noise when you turn the steering wheel. And I've already looked at it, and the lower ball joint boots are ripped, and that's where our noise is coming from. So we're going to replace the lower ball joints. Okay, so here's what's going on here. You can see this boot is torn, and there's no grease coming out. It's actually dry. So more than likely, moisture got inside there and just dried it up, probably rusted, and that's why we're hearing that squeaking sound, because it's so dry and tight in there. So we're going to replace both of these lower control arms that come with the ball joint integrated. So these two nuts right here, we're going to take loose. We're going to remove this bolt right here. There's a 18 millimeter bolt hidden up there, and then to get this one out, this is a 15 millimeter head on this bolt, but you can see it's going to hit the body of the car. So to get this out, we're going to remove this whole brace across here, and each side has two 15 millimeter bolts and then an 18 millimeter nut. So let's get to work. Okay, so these are 21 millimeter nuts. So when we remove these nuts, the subframe is going to drop down about an inch or two in the back. It can't fall out. You can put a jack under if it makes it feel better, but we'll use a jack when we push it back up. Didn't even move at all. Those are both 24 millimeter. So we're going to remove this bolt next. This is a 18 millimeter on this end, a 15 on this end. We're going to pull this bolt out of this control arm right here, and this is an 18 millimeter bolt head right here. You want to be careful when you're wrestling these out of here. You don't want to push the steering knuckle out too far and hyperextend the CV joints. So the rear bolt on the rear arm is a 15 millimeter head. But you can see that bolt's going to hit the body, so I'm going to break it loose and start turning it out. Then we'll put a pry bar in here, and we'll just pry the subframe down a little bit in the rear, just enough to get that bolt out. Always a good idea to compare your new parts to your old parts to make sure they're correct. And right here, right out of the gate, you can see there's an issue. This little guy. See how they're different? Same with here. These are actually spacers. These are just stuck on there. They come off and you put them in the steering knuckle of the car and then you put the new ball joint stud into it. So we're going to have to pull these off. And to do that, I got a two-jaw puller. Should do the job. Sometimes these don't go in real easy. It's a good idea to take a wire wheel and just clean the rust off of it. We don't want to tighten that up until we get the other end of this in. Okay, now that everything's started, we can go ahead and tighten everything down.